各位媒体朋友，女士们、先生们，大家上午好。
Ladies and gentlemen, friends from the media, good morning.
十四届全国人大一次会议刚刚举行了闭幕会议。今天我们非常荣幸地邀请到了国务院总理李强和各位副总理与大家见面，并请李总理回答大家的提问。有请李总理。
The first session of the 14th National People's Congress just closed. We are privileged to invite Premier of the State Council Li Qiang and the Vice Premiers to meet with the press and invite Premier Li to answer your questions. And I'll give the floor to the Premier.
大家好，很高兴啊，今天能够与各位媒体朋友、各位记者在这里见面交流。首先我要感谢大家为报道这一次中国两会所付出的辛劳。
Good morning. I am happy to meet with the press today. I want to first of all thank you for your hard work in covering the two sessions.
我们衷心感谢党和人民的信任，也深知肩负的责任重大，使命光荣。
We thank the party and the people for their trust, and we're deeply aware of the important responsibilities and the glorious mission upon our shoulders.
我们一定在以习近平同志为核心的党中央坚强领导下，紧紧依靠广大人民，以奋发有为的精神状态和时时放心不下的责任意识，忠实履行宪法和法律赋予的职责，勇毅前行，廉洁奉公，鞠躬尽瘁，不辱使命。
We will follow the strong leadership of the CPC Central Committee with Comrade Xi Jinping at its core, rely closely on our people, and faithfully perform the duties entrusted by the Constitution and laws with an enterprising spirit and a strong sense of responsibility. We will press ahead with grit, stay honest and upright, exert our utmost, and live up to our mission.
下面就请各位记者提问吧。
I'm now ready to take your questions.
好，非常感谢李总理。下面开始提问。
请中区第三排第一位男士提问，谢谢。
谢谢主持人。总理您好，中央广播电视总台记者提问。首先也要向您和四位副总理履新表示祝贺。新一届政府的任期未来五年，对于全面建设社会主义现代化国家来说是开局起步的关键时期，所以国内外非常关注新一届政府的工作。我的问题是，新一届政府的施政目标是什么？有哪些工作重点？将会怎样来开展工作？谢谢。
China Central Television. First of all, congratulations to you, Mr. Premier, and the four vice premiers. The coming 5 years will be crucial for getting our efforts to build a modern socialist country in all respects off to a good start. People, both at home and abroad, are following closely the work of the new government. So my question is, what are the goals and priorities of the new government? How will the government carry out its work?
谢谢你的祝贺。也感谢大家对我们新一届政府工作的关心。
Thank you for your congratulations, and I also want to thank you for your interest in the work of the new government.
去年十月份召开的党的二十大，对我们国家今后五年和更长时间的发展做了全面的战略部署。应该说，大家比较关心的重大问题都能在二十大的报告当中找到清晰的答案。
The 20th National Congress of the Communist Party of China last year laid out a comprehensive and a strategic plan for the country's development in the next 5 years and beyond. For most of the important issues that are of interest to the people, the 20th Party Congress report has provided clear answers.
新一届政府的工作就是要把党中央的决策部署、 贯彻好、落实好，把二十大破坏的宏伟蓝图变成施工图，与全国人民一道，一步一个脚印的把施工图、宏伟蓝图变成美好的现实。
The task of the new government is to implement and deliver on the important decisions and plans laid out by the Party's Central Committee. Turn the inspiring blueprint drawn up at the 20th Party Congress into an implementation scheme, and work with our people to step by step turn this blueprint into a beautiful reality.
在具体工作中，我们可能要重点把握的是这么几个方面。第一，要牢固树立以人民为中心的发展思想。
In carrying out our work, we will focus on the following priorities. The first priority is we will firmly establish a people-centered development approach.
说到底，党和政府的一切工作，宗旨就是为民造福。习总书记说，人民对美好生活的向往，就是我们的奋斗目标。我们一定会始终牢记人民政府前面人民这两个字，扎扎实实地办好每一件民生实事。
The ultimate aim of the work of the party and the government is to improve the well-being of the people. As General Secretary Xi Jinping pointed out, people's aspiration for a better life is our goal. We will always bear in mind this is a people's government.And we will make solid efforts on every piece of work concerning people's livelihood.
客观地说，绝大部分老百姓不会天天盯牢看这个 GDP 到底增加了多少。大家更在乎的、更关心的，一定是自己身边的具体事，像住房、就业、收入、教育、医疗、生态环境。等等，政府工作就是要贴近老百姓的实际感受，去谋划、去推进，要真正做到民有所盼，政有所为。
Honestly speaking, most people do not keep their eyes on GDP growth all the time. What they care more about are the things that happen in their everyday life, like housing, employment.Income, education, medical services, and the environment. Therefore, the government must always plan and carry out its work in light of what the people feel and act according to people's wish.
第二，要集中力量推动高质量发展。大家已经注意到了，这一次，习近平总书记。在参加江苏代表团审议的时候，特别强调要牢牢把握高质量发展这个首要任务。
Second, we will focus our efforts on promoting high-quality development. You may have noticed that when attending the deliberation by the MPC deputies from Jiangsu Province.General Secretary Xi Jinping stressed the importance of focusing on the top priority of high-quality development.
确实，我们国家的经济社会发展啊，已经取得了巨大成就。我们的经济总量现在是稳居世界第二，但是发展不平衡、不充分。我们任何一个总量指标，要分摊到。14亿这个人口基数上，人均水平还都是比较有限的。
Indeed, China has made great progress in economic and social development. We are now the second largest economy in the world. That said, China's development is still imbalanced and inadequate. Any aggregate volume, when divided by the 1.4 billion population, will become a small per capita figure.
现在我们的发展。更多的只是解决有没有的问题，下步我们会更加关注解决好不好问题，特别是如何进一步提高我们的科技创新能力，加快建设现代化市场体系，推动发展方式的 绿色转型等等吧。
Currently, our development is focused on providing for people's basic needs, and going forward, the focus will be shifted towards delivering a life of better quality for the people. In particular, we will enhance our capacity in science, technology, and innovation, accelerate the building of a modern market system, and transition toward green development.
总的来讲，我们还是要在三句话上下功夫，完整、准确、全面地贯彻新发展理念，加快构建新发展格局，着力推进高质量发展。这三句话我们还要再下功夫。
All in all, we will make greater efforts to fully and faithfully apply the new development philosophy on all fronts, move faster to create a new pattern for development, and concentrate our efforts on promoting high-quality development.
第三，坚定不移深化改革开放。
Third priority, we will remain steadfast in deepening reform and opening up.
我们常说改革开放是决定当代中国命运的关键一招，在下一步推进中国式现代化，在实现第二个百年奋斗目标的历史过程当中，我认为我们还必须吃改革饭，走开放路。
As we often say, reform and opening up is a crucial move that has made China what it is today. In the historical process of advancing Chinese modernization and realizing the second centenary goal, we must continue to firmly pursue the path of reform and opening up.
我们要坚持社会主义市场经济的改革取向，要坚持高水平对外开放，要通过深化改革开放来不断地增强我们国家发展的动力和活力。
We will keep to the direction of socialist market economy reform, promote higher level opening up, and inject stronger vitality into China's development by deepening reform.
谢谢。
Thank you.
请继续提问。
请中区第二排左起第三位 CNBC 郑一伦。
Thank you. From CNBC. Premier Li, this year marks the first since the peak of COVID in China, and many expect the economy to rebound in the near term. What policies will China enact to achieve its full-year growth target? What drivers of growth and drags on the economy does China expect in the year ahead and in the next 5 years? What kinds of policies does China plan to pursue in the next 5 years to support sustainable high-quality growth? And finally, how effective have policies been in the last few years in reducing debt, disorderly expansion of capital,and other systemic risks in China. Thank you.
美国消费者新闻与商业频道，今年是中国疫情过封后的第一年，许多人预期经济将在短期内反弹。中国准备采取怎样的措施来实现全年的经济增长目标？中国经济在今年及接下来的五年将面临哪些有利和不利的因素？未来五年，中国计划采取什么样的政策来支持可持续高质量增长？近几年，中国在应对债务、资本无序扩张等系统性风险方面的政策取得了哪些成效？
这位记者朋友，很会抓机会。他这个一口气，我刚才记了一下，是四个问题、六个方面的内容。时间关系，对不起，我只能摘要的做些回答。
I see our journalist has really made the most of the opportunity of asking the question. I counted four questions on six subjects, but due to time limit, I can only briefly answer your questions.
确实啊，今年世界经济形势不容乐观，不确定、不稳定、难以预料的因素还很多，而且有时候还会出现一些偶发的问题。如何稳增长，恐怕不仅是对我们中国，对世界各地都是一个现实的考验。
Indeed, the prospect of the global economy this year is not optimistic. We see many factors of uncertainty and instability, and also unpredictable factors. And sometimes there will also be unexpected incidents. Stabilizing economic growth is a challenging task, not just for China, but for all countries in the world.
今年我们中国的经济增长的预期目标啊，现在定5%左右。这是综合考虑了各方面的因素以后确定的。当然现在我们经济总量大了，我们总量已经过了120万亿，而且现在新的挑战也不少。在这种高基数上要实行，要达到这么一个5%左右的增长目标，恐怕也不是件容易的事，需要我们倍加努力。
This year, we have set the GDP growth target at around 5%, which is based on consideration of various factors. Currently, China's total economic output has already exceeded 120 trillion RMB yuan. We also face quite a number of new challenges. So to achieve around 5% growth on such a high base figure is not an easy task, and it would require redoubled efforts.
有关经济发展的一些具体政策部署，实际上在去年召开的中央经济工作会上已经做了全面的部署。
As for the specific economic policies, the Central Economic Work Conference last year already laid out a comprehensive plan.
基本取向是坚持稳字当头、稳中取进，要推动整个经济运行整体向好。经济运行的整体向好。
Basically, we will keep to the general principles of prioritizing stability and seeking progress while maintaining stability, and we will push for a turnaround in overall economic performance.
说回稳，最重要的还是稳增长、稳物价、稳就业。说回进，关键就是要在推动高质量发展上有新的进步。
On stability, the emphasis will be placed on ensuring stable growth, stable prices, and stable jobs. On progress, the key will be making progress on high-quality development.
具体工作当中，恐怕有这么几件事是我们下步重点考虑的，或者说要打好这么几套组合拳。
As for our specific work going forward, we will introduce a number of policy combinations.
第一，要打好宏观政策的组合拳。第二，要打好扩大需求的组合拳，包括内需、外需、投资。第三，要打好改革创新的组合拳，包括制度创新、科技创新、产业创新等等。第四，要打好防范化解风险的组合拳。
We will introduce policy combinations, including the following aspects: combination of macro policies, combination policies for expanding demand, both domestic and external demand, and also investment. Policies for advancing reform and innovation, including institutional innovation, innovation in science, technology, and industrial innovation.And also a combination of policies for preventing and diffusing risks.
这些组合拳每一套都有非常丰富的具体内涵，时间关系我不展开来说了。我们还会根据实践的需要，不断的充实、调整、优化这些组合拳的具体内容。
These policy combinations will all be supported by concrete implementing steps. Due to the interest of time, I will not elaborate on them, but we will enrich, adjust, and improve these policy combinations in the course of implementation.
刚才这位记者朋友还问到，中国在经济发展当中有哪一些有利条件和不利因素吧，还是困难啊？确实我们中国经济发展首先是有很多有利条件。
Our journalist also asked about the drivers and drags on the Chinese economy. Indeed, China's economic development is supported by quite a number of advantages.
比如我们的 市场规模巨大，不可替代性，我们的产业体系完备，我们的人力资源丰富，我们的发展基础很厚实，特别重要的是我们国家制度优势显著。
For example, we have a supersized market, which is irreplaceable. We have a well-functioning industrial system. We have rich supply of human resources. We have a strong development foundation. But most importantly, we have notable institutional strength.
讲到困难，实际上大家都有困难。我们今年中国的困难也会不少。但是静下心想一想，我们哪个时候哪一年没有碰到困难？我们从来是在不断克服困难当中实现新的发展，创造新的奇迹的。
Talk about drags on the Chinese economy or difficulties. I think all countries are confronted with some difficulties, and we see no less difficulty for China this year.But think about it. Is there any single period or any single year where we had no difficulty at all? The Chinese people have always been managed to pull through difficult time and achieve new progress and create new miracles.
像我们这一代人小时候啊，听的最多的故事是大禹治水、愚公移山、精卫填海。夸父逐日等等都很励志，讲的都是不怕困难，不畏艰险，勇于斗争，自强不息的精神。中国人从来没有被任何困难所压倒。
People of my generation are familiar with stories of heroes in Chinese legends like 大禹 who tamed the flood, 愚公 who moved the mountains,Jin Wei, who carried stones to fill up the ocean, and Kua Fu, who chased after the sun. These inspiring stories are testament to the spirit of resilience, tenacity, and perseverance that has defined the Chinese nation. We, the Chinese people, have never been crushed by any difficulty.
从今年开年以后这几个两个来月啊，经济运行情况看，我们国家中国的经济呀。出现了企稳回升的态势，我看最近一些国际机构也调高了对中国今年经济的预期。
As the economic performance in the first 2 months of this year demonstrates, the Chinese economy is stabilizing and picking up again, and some international organizations have also revised upward their projections for China's economic growth this year.
对中国经济的前景，我想用八个字来概括，叫做“长风破浪，未来可期”。对此，我充满信心。
To sum up, I believe the Chinese economy will break wings and waves and sail toward a brighter future. I have full confidence in that.
谢谢。
Thank you.
请继续提问。
请南区第二排第二位女士提问，谢谢。
谢谢李总理，你好，我是来自香港凤凰卫视凤凰网凤凰秀的记者胡玲。这几年其实我们可以看到，香港实现了由乱到治的一个根本性的转折啊，香港稳定下来了。那么其实这个过程当中呢，大家也会说，那么发展问题又摆在了眼前。那么对于香港来说的话，随着整个世界政经局势还有环境的变化，我关注到有评论认为，其实港澳目前的竞争力啊已经被弱化了。我就想请问，您会如何来看待港澳未来的发展前景？另外呢，大家其实非常关注的就是中央政府下一步还会有哪些措施来更好的支持港澳，来发挥自己的优势和特长，实现更好的发展呢？谢谢。
Phoenix TV, in recent years, Hong Kong has restored order and stability.Marking a major turnaround in the situation. And now development in Hong Kong has captured the attention of many. But due to changes in international economic and political landscape, some believe that the international competitiveness of Hong Kong and Macau are weakening. So what is your assessment of the future prospect of Hong Kong and Macau? And how will the central government support Hong Kong and Macau in leveraging their strengths and unique features and achieve better development?
中央政府啊，始终高度重视发挥香港、澳门的独特优势和特点。回归以来，在国家的大力支持下，香港的国际金融中心、国际贸易中心、国际航运中心三大中心的地位没有变，而且得到了加强和巩固。澳门作为国际旅游休闲中心，仍然是享誉全球。
The central government has all along attached high importance to helping Hong Kong and Macau leveraging their unique strengths and position. Since the return of Hong Kong and Macau to the motherland with the support of the country, Hong Kong's position as a global financial, trading and shipping center has not changed. On the contrary, it has been strengthened and consolidated. And Macau has also built itself into a world-renowned tourism and leisure center.
确实这几年受各种因素影响吧，香港、澳门在发展当中遇到了一些困难，但是我认为这还是暂时的困难，是发展中的困难。
It is true that in recent years, due to various factors, both Hong Kong and Macau have experienced some difficulties in their development. But I believe these are temporary difficulties that have arisen in the course of development.
中央政府将全面准确、坚定不移地贯彻一国两制方针，全力支持香港、澳门融入国家发展大局，全力支持香港、澳门发展经济、改善民生，全力支持香港、澳门进一步提升国际竞争力。
The central government will fully, faithfully, and resolutely implement the policy of one country, two systems. We will give full support to Hong Kong and Macau in integrating into the country's overall development. We will give full support to the two regions in growing their economy and improving people's livelihood. We will give full support to the two regions in further building their global competitiveness.
我相信啊，有祖国作为坚强后盾，有一国两制制度保障，香港、澳门的作用和地位只会加强，不会削弱。香港、澳门的明天一定会更加美好。
I'm confident with the strong backing of the motherland and the institutional safeguards of the one country, two systems policy, Hong Kong and Macau will only strengthen their position and role, and Hong Kong and Macau will enjoy an even brighter future.
谢谢。
Thank you.
请继续提问。
请北区第一排联合早报杨丹士。
谢谢新加坡联合早报。李总理您好，您早年做过温州市委书记，那温州市以及您后来任职的浙江省、江苏以及上海都是中国民营经济非常发达的地方，那您对民营经济也有很深的了解，想请问您认为中国还需要采取哪些措施提振民企的信心，支持民企的发展，那还有哪些地方做得不够需要补齐？谢谢。
联合早报 from Singapore。Mr. Premier, you had worked as the party secretary in Wenzhou in your earlier career. Both Wenzhou and other places you later worked, Zhejiang, Jiangsu, and Shanghai, all have an advanced private economy. And we know that you also have a keen insight of the private economy. So in your view, what additional measures need to be taken to boost the confidence of private companies and support their development? What are the areas where further efforts are needed?
大家可能一定关注到，这次全国两会期间，习近平总书记去看望全国政协委员的时候，特别就民营经济、民营企业的健康发展、高质量发展做了深刻的阐述，引起了强烈反响。特别是广大民营企业家深受鼓舞，深感振奋。倍加激励。
You may have noted that when meeting with the CPPCC National Committee members during the two sessions, General Secretary Xi Jinping elaborated on the importance of ensuring healthy and high-quality development of private economy and private entrepreneurs. General Secretary Xi's words were very well received and made private entrepreneurs feel both motivated and encouraged.
我确实长期在民营经济相对比较发达的地方工作，因此也有很多的机会接触民营企业家，与他们交流。应该说，对他们发展当中的一些期盼和包括遇到的一些困难，还是比较了解的。
I have worked in localities with a strong private economy for a long time, and I have had the opportunities to talk with local entrepreneurs on various occasions, and I should say I am pretty well informed of their aspirations and the difficulties they have faced in their development.
刚才这位记者问到这个问题，我想借今天这个机会，主要表达这么几层意思，三层意思吧。
I want to take this opportunity to mainly convey the following messages.
第一，两个毫不动摇，是我们国家基本经济制度的重要内容，是长久之策，过去没有变，以后更不会变。
First, the policy of two unswervings, namely unswervingly consolidating and developing the public sector, and unswervingly encouraging, supporting, and guiding the development of the non-public sector, is a basic element of China's basic economic system. This is a long-term policy that has not changed in the past and will not change in the future.
确实，特别是去年有一段时间，社会上出现了一些对民营经济发展的不正确议论、言论，使一些企业家心存忧虑。其实，在发展民营经济这个问题上，党中央的方针政策一直是十分明确的。你看，党的十九大、党的二十大，去年底召开的中央经济工作会议，都对此做了强调。
Indeed, last year there were some inappropriate discussions about private entrepreneurs, which made them feel frustrated. But as a matter of fact, the Party Central Committee has clear policies and principles regarding the development of the private economy. Both the 19th and 20th National Congresses and the Central Economic Work Conference last year all reaffirmed these policies and principles.
我们是旗帜鲜明的，坚定不移的。
Our commitment in this regard is unequivocal and steadfast.
第二个我想表达的意思是，民营经济的发展环境会越来越好，发展空间会越来越大。
The second point I want to make is that private entrepreneurs or enterprises will enjoy better environment and a broader space for development.
我们这一届政府将在新的起点上进一步的打造市场化、法治化、国际化的营商环境，平等对待各类不同所有制的企业，依法保护企业的产权、企业家的权益，促进各类经营主体公平竞争，支持民营企业发展壮大。
Standing at a new starting point, this government will continue to foster a market-based and law-based business environment in keeping with international standards, treat companies under all types of ownership as equals, protect the property rights of enterprises and the rights and interests of entrepreneurs in accordance with law, and we will create a level playing field for all kinds of market entities, and will make further efforts to support private entrepreneurs grow and thrive.
从发展空间来看，我们国家具有超级规模的市场需求，现在还有很多新领域需要大家去开拓，还有很多新赛道 需要大家去参与，应该说各种发展机遇是很多很多的，民营经济一定是大有可为。
As for development space, China has a supersized market with huge demand. There are a lot of new sectors and new racing tracks that can be tapped. All this promises great opportunities for private entrepreneurs.
第三点我想说的，时代呼唤广大民营企业家要谱写新的创业史。
The third point,The new era inspires private entrepreneurs to write their new entrepreneurship stories.
这也是我今天特别想说的。大家知道，经济发展有它内在的客观规律，也依赖客观条件，但是很需要很强的人的这种内在冲动、主观能动性。我们民营企业家一定要进一步弘扬优秀企业家精神，坚定信心再出发。
This is a point I particularly want to make on this occasion. As we all know, economic development follows certain economic laws and depends on the conditions available. However, it is even more important to bring out people's initiative.So I do hope that private entrepreneurs will carry forward their entrepreneurial spirit and strengthen confidence as they start their new journey.
说到这里啊，我就想起在上个世纪八九十年代，在我的老家浙江和江苏那时候发展个体私营经济和乡镇企业的时候提出来的打造的四千精神，就是走遍千山万水，想尽千方百计，说遍千言万语，吃尽千辛万苦。
Talking about this, I remember that back in the 1980s and 90s, when my hometown Zhejiang Province and the neighboring Jiangsu Province were developing the private economy and township enterprises, the local entrepreneurs cultivated a strong pioneering spirit.To reach their goals, they were willing to explore all paths, go through all troubles, try all means, and endure all hardships.
虽然现在我们创业的条件、创业的环境、创业的模式与过去发生了很大的变化，但是当时那种筚路蓝缕、披荆斩棘的创业精神是永远需要的。
Although the conditions, environment, and models of entrepreneurship are vastly different today, this kind of pioneering spirit of clearing obstacles and blazing new trails will always be needed.
我们各级干部啊，要真诚的、真心的关心支持民营企业发展，要与民营企业家交朋友，构建亲亲政商关系。要带头营造尊重企业家、尊重创业者良好氛围。
Government officials at all levels must sincerely care for and support the development of private enterprises, make friends with private entrepreneurs, build clean and cordial relations with them, and take the lead in promoting a culture of respect for pioneers and entrepreneurs.
我相信在新时代、新征程上，我们广大民营企业家一定会谱写出更加辉煌的新的创业史。
I'm confident that in the new era and on their new journey, our private entrepreneurs will continue to write their exciting entrepreneurship stories.
谢谢。
Thank you.
请继续提问。
请南区。第四排第四位女士提问，谢谢。
总理您好，我是澎湃新闻的记者，网民呢对一些热点民生问题高度关注，请问今年我国就业形势依然严峻，政府将采取哪些措施稳就业呢？去年中国出现了多年未有的人口负增长，这是否意味着人口红利即将消失？ 今年会不会出台延迟退休政策呢？谢谢。
The paper. The netizens are all following closely issues concerning their livelihood. But this year, the employment situation is going to remain serious in China. So what steps will the government take to stabilize employment? And last year, China's population experienced negative growth for the first time in years. Does that mean China's demographic dividend is disappearing? And will the government introduce the policy of postponed retirement this year?
我非常愿意回答网民的关切啊，我自己也可以说是个老网民了。我现在如果有空也会上上网，看看大家关心什么，提了哪些建议和意见。
I'm happy to answer questions raised by the netizens. I would call myself a veteran netizen because when I have time, I also go online quite a lot to see what the netizens are thinking and what suggestions they have for the work of the government.
刚才这位记者实际上是提了三个问题。第一个是就业。我先回答你第一个问题。
The journalist actually asked three questions. The first question is on employment.
确实就业是民生之本，但要解决就业问题，我认为最根本的一条还是要靠发展经济。
Indeed, employment is the cornerstone of people's livelihood, but ultimately the solution to job creation lies in economic growth.
下部具体工作当中啊，我们会全面落实就业优先的战略，我们会进一步加大相关的政策支持力度，特别是就业服务、技能培训这方面的政策力度会进一步加大。另外，我们一定会综合施策，扩大和稳定现代就业岗位。还有就是对现在新的一种就业形态，我们既要支持，另外要规范发展。
As for the specific steps going forward, we will continue to pursue an employment-first strategy. We will increase government support in terms of employment services and technical training. We will take multiple steps to stabilize and expand employment. We will also support and regulate the development of new forms of employment.
我看今年好像网上比较关心是大学生就业。因为今年大学毕业生啊，在中国是再创新高，预计现在今年毕业的大学生规模是1158万人。这个对于就业来讲，确实是增加了一定的压力，但是从发展的角度，这是好事。这么多的年轻人走上新的岗位，一定会为我们这个社会注入蓬勃的朝气和新的活力。
I noticed that people on the internet care a lot about the employment of college graduates. Indeed, this year we expect to see 11.58 million college graduates entering the workforce, which will be a record high. This large number certainly adds pressure to employment, but if we look at it from a development perspective, it could be a good thing, because with so many young people entering the workforce, they can inject energy and vitality into our society.
下步我们要广开就业渠道，要帮助支持年轻人通过自己的劳动和奋斗去实现自己更加美好的人生价值。
Going forward, we will further expand channels of employment, and in particular, we will help and support young people to realize their personal values through hard work.
刚才你提的第二个问题好像负增长，人口负增长，确实我也看到，对我们国家人口增长由正转负，大家有所担忧，有的人担心我们国家的人口红利是不是就此消失了？我看恐怕不是这么简单。
Your second question concerns population growth. I've also noticed that the negative population growth in China has caused much concern, and some people are worried that China's demographic dividend may be disappearing. But I don't think it is that simple.
人口红利既要看人口数量， 更要看人口质量，既要看人口数，更要看人才数。
When assessing demographic dividend, we should look at not just the quantity, but also the quality of population. We should not just look at the sheer size of the population, but also look at the scale of high caliber workforce.
我们国家现在劳动力总数，或者准确表述应该是适合劳动年龄人口已经有近九亿人，而且每年新增劳动力是1500万人。人力资源丰富仍然是我们中国一个巨大优势，或者说显著优势。
Now we have close to 900 million working age population, and every year 15 million people join the workforce. A rich supply of human resources remains China's notable strength.
更重要的是，我们国家接受高等教育的人口已经超过2.4亿，每年新增的劳动力平均受教育的年限已经达到14年。
More importantly, we have more than 240 million people with experience in higher education, and the average length of education received by new entrants to the workforce has increased to 14 years.
因此可以说，我们的人口红利并没有消失，人才红利正在逐步形成，发展的动力依旧强劲。
Therefore, China's demographic dividend has not disappeared, and our talent dividend is in the making. The driving force for China's development remains strong and robust.
当然，对人口增减变化带来的一系列的社会问题，我们一定是进一步的深入研究，积极应对。
That said, we will conduct careful study on the social problems that may be brought by the changes in population and respond with appropriate steps.
刚才提的第三个问题，退休政策，对这件事，我看到晚上也是很关心。我们一定会认真研究，充分论证，在合适的时候稳妥推出。
Your third question concerns postponement policy. I noticed that it is also a quite hot topic on the internet. We will conduct rigorous studies and a thorough analysis to roll out the policy prudently in due course.
谢谢。
Thank you.
请继续提问。
请中区第四排中间位置，乌兹别克斯坦《人民言论报》鲁斯兰。
Ruslan Kinjaev, Narodnoye Slovo newspaper, Uzbekistan. My question is, China kept strict COVID measures in place for over 2 years. As some people in the world have questioned, were those measures truly necessary? And what preparation has China made for a potential new wave of COVID? 谢谢。
Uzbekistan 人民言论报。国际上有些人质疑，相比于其他国家，中国在防疫上实施了2年多的严控，是否确有必要？应对未来可能出现的新一波疫情，中国做了哪些准备？
疫情3年，中国人民在中国共产党的坚强领导下，全国上下同心抗疫，现在已经取得重大决定性胜利。
For over 3 years, under the strong leadership of the Communist Party of China, the Chinese people have united in fighting COVID-19, and now we have achieved major and decisive victory in the battle against the disease.
3年来，我们始终坚持人民至上、生命至上，坚持科学精准防控，因时因势不断地优化调整各种防控措施。
For the past 3 years, we have always put the people and their lives above everything else. We have adopted a well-conceived and targeted control approach and adjusted and improved our response measures in light of changing conditions.
在疫情初期传播力比较强的时候，我们国家果断采取措施，实行一类加管，有效地保护了人民的生命安全和身体健康，也为我们国家的疫苗开发、药物开发以及后来疫苗接种的普及赢得了宝贵时间。
At the beginning of the pandemic, when the virus was highly pathogenic, we made timely responsewith containment measures for Class A infectious disease. Such an effort helped protect people's life and health and won us valuable time for the R&D of vaccines and medicines and for the rolling out of vaccination.
后来随着这个病毒的致病力的减弱，也随着我们国家防控能力的提高，我们又对一系列防控措施进行了优化调整，适时的进行了防控的转段，实行了一类一管。
At the later stage, when the virus became less pathogenic, and with the increase in China's capacity for pandemic control, we have improved and adjusted our COVID response measures and achieved a smooth transition in COVID response phase by putting COVID back to the category of Class B infectious disease.
在我们这样一个人口众多、发展不平衡的大国，我们只用了不到两个月的时间，实现了疫情防控的平稳转段，较快地恢复了经济社会的正常秩序，这是很了不起的。
China is a country with a large population and imbalanced development, yet it only took us less than 2 months to achieve a smooth transition in COVID response phase and restored normal economic and social order in a relatively short span of time. This is indeed a remarkable achievement.
实践证明，中国的各项疫情防控的各项策略措施是完全正确的，防控的成效是巨大的。
What has happened proves that China's COVID strategies and measures are completely right, and our COVID response has been highly effective.
人类与病毒做斗争啊，是一个长期的、漫长的历史过程。现在新冠病毒传播的风险依然存在，我们一直在跟踪研判，及时做好预警预测，而且我们现在也制定了不同情景下、不同场景怎么样应对可能出现的疫情传播风险的各种应对预案。
Humanity's battle against the virus is a long-term and historical process. Currently, the risk of virus transmission still exists. So we will continue to follow and study the evolving situation.Build up our capacity for early warning and forecast, and we have also made contingency plans for different kinds of scenarios.
我们还会不断地加强各级医疗卫生服务体系的建设，加快新的疫苗药物的开发，同时我们一直保持与国际社会的沟通合作，共同维护人类健康福祉。
We will also strengthen medical and health service systems at all levels and speed up the development of new vaccines and drugs. We have also been engaged in communication and cooperation with the international community to jointly protect the health and well-being of humanity.
谢谢。
Thank you.
请继续提问。请北区第三排。第一位男士提问，谢谢。
李总理你好，我是台湾联合报记者。大陆方面表示，将始终将关爱、尊重以及造福台湾同胞。随着大陆疫情防控的调整跟优化，两岸民众都希望能够尽快全面恢复两岸的正常交流跟往来。请问总理，大陆在推动两岸经济文化合作交流以及人员的往来方面有何规划？谢谢。
United Daily News Group from Taiwan. The mainland says it always respect, care about, and promote the well-being of compatriots in Taiwan. So with the adjustment and improvement of COVID protocols on the mainland, people on both sides of the straits look forward to the early restoration of normal exchanges. So what measures will the mainland take to promote the economic and cultural exchanges and the personnel travel across the straits?
两岸同胞是一家人，我们常说血浓于水，打断骨头连着筋。
Chinese on both sides of the Taiwan Straits are members of one and the same family. We share an unbreakable bond of blood and kinship.
我们将在一个中国原则和九二共识的基础上，继续推进两岸的经济、文化交流和合作，要让更多的台胞、台企到大陆来，不仅是让他们愿意来，还要融得进，有更好的发展。
We will continue to promote economic and cultural exchanges and cooperation across the Taiwan Straits on the basis of the One China Principle and the 1992 Consensus. And we also encourage more Taiwan compatriots and businesses to come to the mainland. We hope they will not just be willing to come to the mainland, but also be able to integrate into the local communities and achieve better development.
确实，像刚才记者先生说的，早日实现两岸的正常往来，恢复常态化的合作，是我们的共同期盼，更需要我们共同努力。
Just as the journalist said, the early restoration of normal exchanges and regular cooperation between the two sides of the Taiwan Straits is our shared aspiration and requires our joint efforts.
谢谢。
Thank you.
请继续提问。请中区第二排第三位男士提问，谢谢。
谢谢。总理您好，我是人民日报记者。全面建设社会主义现代化国家最艰巨最繁重的任务仍然在农村。请问总理，本届政府在推进乡村振兴上有哪些考虑？对保障中国粮食安全有哪些举措？谢谢。
People's Daily. In building a modern socialist country, the most arduous and complex task is in the countryside. So what plan does this government have in promoting rural revitalization, and what measures will be taken to ensure China's food security?
中国是一个农业大国，我们现在还有近5亿人常住在农村，可以说没有农业农村的现代化，社会主义现代化是不全面的。
China is a major agricultural country. We now still have close to 500 million people permanently resided in the countryside. So without the modernization of rural sector and agriculture, socialist modernization will be not complete.
去年底，党中央召开了农村工作会议，习近平总书记在会上发表了重要讲话，专门就建设农业强国、抓好三农工作、推进乡村振兴提出了全面的要求。当前我们整个农业农村工作，就是要按照中央的要求把每项工作抓落实。
During the Central Rural Work Conference last year, General Secretary Xi Jinping gave an important speechand made comprehensive instructions on building a strong agricultural country, advancing work relating to agriculture, rural development of farmers, and promoting rural revitalization. So our task is to deliver on the important decisions and instructions made by the Party Central Committee.
就乡村振兴这件事来讲，我看下一步要突出或者要关注三个关键词。
In promoting rural revitalization, we will focus on the following three keywords.
第一是全面，乡村振兴不仅仅是发展经济，我觉得更重要的，要全面彰显乡村的价值，包括经济价值、生态价值、社会价值、文化价值。 等等。
The first keyword is comprehensive. Rural revitalization is not just about economic growth. In my view, it is also important to bring out the economic, ecological, social, and cultural values of the countryside.
第二个关键词叫特色。中国地域辽阔，十里不同风，百里不同俗啊，因此各地必须因地制宜，打造各具特色的乡村风貌，特别要注意保护好、传承好地域文化、乡土文化，不能搞成千村一色、千村一面。
The second keyword is distinctive features. China is a vast country. Cultures and customs vary from village to village, even though they may be just miles apart. So different localities must develop countrysides based on local conditions. It is important to protect and preserve the local and rural culture, and also avoid a situation where all villages look the same.
第三个关键词是改革，要通过深化农村改革来促进乡村振兴。农民是乡村振兴的主体，我们一定要充分调动广大农民的积极性，让农民参与到乡村振兴中来，而且要让农民更多的分享由于改革发展带来的成果。
The third keyword is reform. We need to deepen reform of the rural sector to provide drivers for rural revitalization. Farmers are the principal actors in rural revitalization. We need to bring out their initiative and let them take part in rural revitalization and sharing the benefits of reform and development.
刚才这位记者还问到粮食安全问题。我们国家已经连续八年年粮食产量超过 1.3 万亿斤，总体上看，我们的粮食安全是有保障的。
The journalist also asked a question about food security. The total grain output in China has stayed above 650 million metric tons for 8 years in a row. So on the whole, food security is well guaranteed in this country.
下步我们会抓住两个要害，第一是耕地，第二是种植，不断地提高我们国家的粮食生产能力。
Going forward, we will further increase our grain production capacity by focusing on two key factors, arable land and seeds.
这里我特别想跟我们的农民朋友说句话。国家支持粮食生产的政策只会增加，不会减少。鼓励大家多种粮，一定要确保14亿中国人的饭碗牢牢地端在我们自己手中。
Here I want to let our farmers' friends know that the government's policy in support of grain production will only increase, not decrease, and we encourage our farmers to produce more grains so as to make sure.That the rice bowl of the 1.4 billion Chinese people will always be firmly held in our own hands.
谢谢。
Thank you.
请继续提问。
请南区第三排左起第一位，中央卫视方浩明。
李总理你好 ，I am from CATV. My question is, the world is witnessing more geopolitical frictions and signs of deglobalization.Meanwhile, China-U.S. relations remain under serious strain. Although China has been reassuring the world of its commitment to reform and opening up, foreign businesses remain wary and some are considering relocation. Will China adjust its opening up policy? How do you see the current China-U.S. ties? And what are the prospects that the relations might improve? 谢谢。
中阿卫视，当前地缘政治摩擦和去全球化加剧，中美关系紧张对立。虽然中国一直强调坚定不移地推进改革开放，但外资外企依然难以感到安心，有的开始考虑撤离。请问，中国的对外开放政策会有变化吗？您如何看待当前的中美关系及其改善前景？
今年呢是中国改革开放45周年，改革开放发展了中国，也影响了世界。
This year marks the 45th anniversary of the launch of reform and opening up in China. Reform and opening up have enabled China to develop itself and also made an impact on the whole world.
据我掌握的情况资料看啊，绝大多数外资企业仍然是看好在华的发展前景的。去年我们中国实际利用外资是1890多亿美元，再创历史新高。这个数据，辽国做个比较，与疫情之前，就3年前，我们还多了近500亿美元，说明，不好意思，说明中国仍然是全球的投资高地。
From what I learned, most foreign companies are still optimistic about their development prospect in China. Last year, China's utilized foreign investment totaled $189 billion, which is again a record high, and it is even close to $50 billion more than 3 years ago or before the pandemic. And this demonstrates that China remains a popular destination for global investment.
对外开放是我们国家的基本国策，不管外部形势发生什么变化，我们一定是坚定不移地向前推进。
Opening up is a basic state policy for China. No matter how the external situation may evolve, we will stay firmly committed to pursuing this policy.
这里我特别想说一说中国国际进口博览会，这是中国主动向外、向世界开放市场、共享发展机遇的重大举措。
Here I want to mention in particular China International Import Expo, or CIIE. CIIE is a major step taken by China to open its market with the world and share its development opportunities with the world.
进博会已经在上海连续办了5届，即使在疫情情况下也从来没有中断，我很荣幸5届我都参加了。
The CIIE has been held uninterrupted for 5 years in Shanghai. Even during the pandemic, it was still held as scheduled, and I had the honor to attend all the 5 editions of CIIE.
我如果没记错的话，去年有127个国家和地区，2800多家企业参展，一次性展出的面积多达35万平方米。
If I remember this correctly, last year there were over 2,800 enterprises from 127 countries and regions attending the expo, and the total exhibition space was over 350,000 square meters.
进博会的举办充分说明，开放的中国大市场是世界各国企业发展的大机遇。
The story of CIIE proves that an open big Chinese market promises big opportunities for companies from around the world.
今年我们还会对接高标准的国际经贸规则，进一步扩大开放。中国对外开放的大门只会越开越大，环境会越来越好，服务会越来越优。
This year, we will further expand opening up in alignment with high-standard international trade rules. China will only open itself wider to the world. We will provide better environment and services for all.
开放的中国，发展的中国，欢迎大家来投资兴业。
An open China, a China that is in the constant process of development, welcomes investors from all over the world.
刚才这位记者先生提到中美关系问题，有关中美关系的具体问题，前几天 秦刚外长在举行的记者会上已经做了全面的阐述，我在这里不再多做重复。我想说的是，当前重要的是要把习近平主席与拜登总统去年十一月份会晤时达成的一系列重要共识转化为具体行动和实际方案。
The journalists also ask about China-US relations, and as for the specific issues concerning China-US relations, our Foreign Minister Qin Gang already elaborated on our position during the press conference a couple of days ago, so I will not go into details. But I want to stress that it is important for us to translate the important consensus reached between President Xi Jinping and President Biden during the meeting last November into actual policies and concrete actions.
我知道在美国国内啊，这几年有人在炒作中美两国脱钩的论调，有烧还比较热，但我不知道到底有多少人在这种炒作当中真正受益。
I know that in recent years, some in the United States have been trumpeting the idea of decoupling with China, and sometimes it could become quite a hot topic on the media. But I wonder how many people can truly benefit from this kind of hype.
据中方统计啊，去年中美的贸易额已经高达近7600亿美元，再创历史新高。
According to Chinese statistics, last year, two-way trade between China and the United States totaled $760 billion, which again set a new record in history.
中美经济，你中有我，我中有你，彼此都从对方的发展当中受益。
China and the United States are closely intertwined economically. We have both benefited from the other side's development.
我去年很长时间是在上海工作，那里有7万多家外资企业，因此我也有很多的机会与包括美资在内的外企的高管接触交流。他们都给我说，看好上海，看好中国。世界应该合作。
For most part of last year, I was working in Shanghai, a city that houses 70,000 foreign companies. So I had a lot of opportunities to talk with the senior managers of multinational corporations, including many American companies. They all told me that they were optimistic about the future of Shanghai and China. They all hope to see cooperation between all countries in the world.
他们都认为啊，合作才能共赢。
They all believe that cooperation is the sure path that will lead to win-win outcomes.
这些都表明，中美可以合作，应该合作，中美合作大有可为。
All this demonstrates that China and the United States can and must cooperate, and there are a lot that the two countries can achieve by working together.
围堵打压对谁都没好处。
Encirclement and suppression is in no one's interest.
谢谢。
Thank you.
请继续提问。请南区第六排第一位男士提问。谢谢。
谢谢主持人。总理您好，我是新华社记者。我们都知道新一届政府面临着艰巨繁重的任务，各方面也都寄予很高的期望，这对政府的履职能力、工作作风都提出了很高的要求。请问新一届政府在加强自身建设方面有哪些考虑？谢谢。
Xinhua News Agency. The new government faces an arduous and complex task and also high expectations from the people. This has raised new requirements on the governing capacity and the conduct of the government. So what plan does the new government has in terms of strengthening government building.
确实啊，如你所说的，新的使命任务对我们 这一届政府同志啊，提出了更高的新的要求。我们将以这一次这一轮的机构改革为契机，切实加强政府自身建设，转变职能，提高效能，改进作风。
Indeed, the new mission and new task have raised new and higher requirements on the new government team. We will take the new round of state institutional reform as an opportunity to strengthen government building. We will further transform government functions, make the government's work more efficient, and improve the conduct of the government.
下部工作当中，我们会突出抓四件事。第一，大兴调查研究之风，党中央已经就此提出了明确要求，国务院要带头抓好贯彻落实。
Going forward, we will focus on the following four priorities. First, we will promote the practice of research and studies. The Party Central Committee has already made clear requirements on that, and the State Council must take the lead in meeting these requirements.
我长期在地方工作，有一个很深的感受，就是坐在办公室碰到的都是问题，下去调研看到的全是办法，高手在民间。
I have worked in local governments for a long time. My experience is that when you sit in the office, you see lots of problems. But when you reach out to the people, you see all kinds of solutions.After all, the brightest minds are among the people.
我们一定会推动各级干部多到基层去调查研究，问计于民，问需于民，向群众学习，拜群众为师，帮助基层解决更多的实际问题。
We will encourage government officials at all levels to engage more with the local communities, to know about what the people need and seek their opinions on the work of the government. They need to learn from the people, take people as their teachers, and help the people solve their actual problems.
特别是长期在大机关做办公室的年轻人，要更多的深入基层，心入基层。更多的接地气。
In particular, young people working in government ministries should reach out to the people, keep people's needs and interests close to their heart, and be down to earth in their work.
第二个要突出抓的是，就是扎实推进依法行政。政府的所有工作必须要在法律框架内进行，政府的所有行政行为必须于法有据。
The second priority is to promote governance in accordance with law. The government must act within the confines of law, and all government conducts must be based on solid legal grounds.
我们会进一步的推进法治政府建设。我们的工作人员要进一步提高用法治思维、法治方式解决问题的能力。
We will continue to promote the building of a law-based government, and public servants need to build up the capacity for applying the method and mentality of rule of law in solving real problems.
第三件我们想要突出抓的事，就是要提高创造性的执行能力。
The third priority is to explore innovative ways in performing our duties.
各级政府各部门、各位公务人员一定要牢固树立发展意识、服务意识。
Government departments at all levels and civil servants must be conscious of their duty to serve the people and promote the country's development.
特别是我们有关部门在履行审批、监管等职责时候，不能只踩刹车不踩油门。不能只设路障不设路标，凡事要更多的做应不应该给他办的价值判断，不能简单的做可不可以判的技术判断。
In particular, when dealing with matters concerning administration, regulation, and approval, the relevant government departments should not just slam on the brake, but also hit on the accelerator. They should not just set up roadblocks, but also need to put up road signs. They should make more value judgment and think about whether something shall be done, instead of just making a purely technical judgment and decide whether something can be done.
我们坚决反对一切形式主义、官僚主义，要真正做有创造力的执行者。
We are firmly opposed to pointless formality and bureaucraticism in all forms, and we must be creative in performing our duties.
第四件我们要突出抓的是坚决守住廉洁底线。我们将始终以严的标准、严的要求推进廉洁政府建设。对一切腐败行为零容忍。
The fourth priority is to uphold the principle of integrity. We will apply stringent standards and requirements in building a clean government and will take a zero tolerance attitude to all acts of corruption.
每一位政府工作人员必须自觉接受监督，真正做到忠诚、干净、当当。
All government officials must subject themselves to supervision and truly meet the requirements of being loyal, upright, and responsible.
谢谢大家。
Thank you.
今天的提问到此结束，感谢李总理和各位副总理，也感谢大家对十四届全国人大一次会议的广泛关注和充分报道。总理记者会到此结束。谢谢。
好，谢谢大家。
I want to thank Premier Li and the Vice Premier.